Okay, we've got multiple benders that resemble this one. This one happens to be a Southwire, but we've got other brands that look in the same similar fashion. Which each of these mechanical benders, you've got to look at the information that's on those benders, learn the operation of those benders specifically, but they all operate in the same fashion. We got a shoe, we got some rollers that keep the pressure. We've got an EMT or a rigid shoe here. The important thing here is to know what you're dealing with. Are you dealing with rigid or IMC? Well, that's this shoe. Are you dealing with EMT? Well, that's the other shoe. Looking at what we've got here, I'm looking at this one. It says rigid and IMC on this. So we're going to have to move it around just a little bit, just to make sure. This says rigid IMC, the other side says EMT. I'll go ahead and spin it all around just to make sure we're on the right path. It takes a while to bend this, to spin this around. It's slow moving. This particular bender, once I get around here, it actually has indications that says, if I'm looking at this, it says EMT. This black hook shoe and that shoe, it's rigid. If I'm looking at EMT, I know I'm bending rigid, I'm on the wrong shoe. So I keep on moving it around until I get to the rigid, which will be this black hook, not the gray hook on this particular bender. As I'm spinning around, you'll see this scale that tells us the degrees. Again, when you get one of these benders and you're playing with one of these benders, it takes you just a moment to familiarize yourself with these benders. Again, they all operate in the same fashion, but they have specialties to them. Bring this around. Now I'm looking at the rigid shoe, which is this shoe with this hook being the black hooks over there. We've got rollers underneath here. These rollers. Those rollers, once you get everything in position and know what you're dealing with, you get to the right rollers. We've got this other set of rollers. This is for our bigger conduit. Once we get to our 1.5-inch rigid or 2-inch rigid, we would set this roller up. It goes in that fashion. We've got a indentation here where this is for rigid. It says I. And then if you're dealing with EMT, you'd spin it around and it says E. So know what we're dealing with. The example we're going to show today is we got a piece of 1.25-inch rigid. We're going to put a 40-inch 90 on this. We need to know what our deductions are for rigid pipe. This has a scale right here. And if it says for rigid pipe and 1.25-inch, it says our deduction is going to be 12 15/16 of an inch. That's how much radius this is going to take up our deduction pattern. So I said 40 inches. We'll take a tape measure, we'll put it on our straight piece of pipe, run down to 40 inches. But the deduction was 12 and 15/16. So I'm going to go for my 40-inch mark. 12 and 15/16, which is right at almost 13 inches, a little bit less. Put a mark right there. That is our starting mark, which is 40 inches subtract 12 and 15/16. Run that mark all the way around. And that's our starting point. Since we know we're dealing with 1.25 on our shoe, 3/4, 1 inch, 1.25. Says it's right there. With also our rollers, we can go ahead and put that 1.25-inch roller in place. We'll slide this into our hook. We're going to look for that end of that hook to be lined up with our mark. And this, we're going to move it just a little bit, tighten it up, see how loose it is, until we get to our mark. Playing with it a little bit here. Tighten it up, make sure we're on our mark. Just a little bit at a time. We actually have on this particular bender, not all of them. Some of them have a readout on the little handheld controller. This has a readout on the the actual body. And it actually tells us that we're at 0 degrees. Don't depend on that always. Always depend on this scale that's on this bender. Those LED readouts, they get destroyed or don't work anymore. If you notice on over here, we actually have a little yellow tick mark sitting out from our shoe. It's sitting right at the zero, a little bit less than zero. We're gonna watch that yellow tick mark go all the way around the scale until we get a little bit past 90. The reason why I say a little bit past 90, we do have spring back. So we're gonna run this bender. Now we got it tight. Right on the mark here. Actually, it's a little bit, I don't like it. So we're gonna back it up just a little bit. We're gonna spring this forward just a little bit to make sure we're right on that end. Now I've got that. We'll push the bend mark. I'm gonna take the little handheld deal and I'm gonna watch this bend as it goes around. I'll notice we're on the mark. I'll push the bend button. Check and make sure we didn't slide off the mark. We're on the roller back here. And we're gonna bend it and I'm gonna watch this yellow tick mark go all the way around to 90 degrees. Right there's 50, just gonna get you. There's 60. 70, 80, and there's 90. We're gonna go past it just a little bit to 93. Now we'll let off of it. And we should be, once I take the pressure off, we should be able to take a level to find if we got a level floor. Whether it's a 90 or not. While it's still in the bender. And I'm looking at it, looking at that mark versus that mark, and I can see that I'm not exactly 90. So I'm gonna give it just a little bit more. So I went to like 95 on my scale. Now I'm gonna back it up, check it again for level, and it's looking good. So I'm happy with that. This time I'll take the little handheld controller and back onto the other side, and I'm gonna unbend this. And as I unbend it, this is gonna get really loose. And I should be able to just get it out of the bender with no problem. Once it's out of the bender, I can set it on the floor. Again, I'll check it for level, but I already did what's on the bender. It looks pretty good. It's a little bit heavy. That's good though. I think the floor is running a little bit out on us. And we'll check for 40 inches, which was our goal. And right at 40 inches is what we got. That's what we're looking for. Again, with these benders, read the directions, read the instructions. There's some extra adjustments on here. Don't mess with those unless you know what you're doing.